And we are back! Welcome back to the channel, dudes. My name is Lag, and this is the Beast from Beyond, the fourth DLC for Infinite Warfare Zombies. Today, I'm going to be showing you how you can get a special weapon called the Entangler with a very easy guide. Make sure you drop a like on the video, subscribe if you're new, and of course, turn on those notifications so you can be alerted to all of my videos. In order to do this, you're going to need to have power turned on, and you're going to need to have access to the Pack-a-Punch room. If you don't know how to do either of these, there is a link down below in the description of this video to both of those tutorials. Check them out. So we're looking for the first skull in Ghost and Skulls to complete this step. There are three potential boxes that are going to be holding this skull. And one of the first possible locations for this box is down here where the electric trap is, just above this door here. If the box is there, you need to cook a grenade, throw it, the box will open, the skull will be in there, and you just shoot it. That easy. The second location where the box could spawn is inside of this cargo room, and all you need to do once again is cook a grenade, throw it at it, and then shoot the skull that comes out. It's not in the first two locations, that is absolutely going to be right here. This is the room with the giant hole in the middle, right up here in this dark kind of corner, right on top of the wall there. You'll see I cook the grenade, the box opens, and I shoot the skull, and that's step one of doing this Easter egg. So once you've got the first skull, you need to head over to the cargo bay room, and you're gonna find these little tiny, very hard to see red X's. They seem to spawn in one of four locations. If you're playing solo, you're gonna need to check all four locations. If you have four players, then this will be pretty easy to locate all four. Now what I did notice is that you kinda have to start a new round, and then look on the ground at the start of the round for the red X. At least that's what I noticed. Anyways, if you look around in on top here, you can find a red X. If you look over here on top of these crates, you can find a red X. If you go on the other side of the room, just on the edge here, you can find a red X. And then across from the crates, a red X could spawn right here. So what you want to do when you find the red X is all you need to do is stand on it. Okay, there'll be a little green circle. Look down, look at that circle. You have to stay in that circle. It's okay if you get hit by zombies, but if they push you out of that circle, you have to try this step again, and I'm pretty sure it's the next round. So I've kind of got a pack-a-punch gun right now. I've got some perks to make this a little bit easier because I'm playing solo. Zombies will keep coming, and in the center of the room, there's a skull that's being raised as time goes by. So just keep killing the zombies, stay in your circle, and when the skull gets all the way up to the top, you're done. All you have to do then is find out where the skull went inside of the cargo room. It's going to move somewhere else. You simply need to get over to it. This is time, so you want to be quick here. Get over to the skull, jump, grab the skull, and then boom, you have the second skull for Ghosts and Skulls, but more importantly, you have the Entangler, which is a kind of a cool weapon. I mean, you could use it as a weapon, but it's actually used to do other things on the map. So guys, hopefully you enjoyed today's video. If you did, be so kind as to drop a like. And as always, it's been your boy Lagging24, and I will see you next time.